In this tutorial, you will learn how you can use data stores inside Integromat. Sounds super techy, but it's actually really simple and it's a really handy feature. So let's just dive right in, then I'll explain what data stores are, what the data structure inside a data store is. Then I'll explain some of the data store modules. And then I want to show you two of my favorite use cases. So inside Integromat, all you have to do is you have to go over to data stores, and then you get a page that looks like this. And then we want to create a new data store. Now, what a data store basically is a kind of a Google Sheet or a database. It's like something we're going to store info into that we can then use later on in the same scenario or in a different scenario. I'll also show you that in those use cases in a bit. So data store name, so you can just give it any name for the use case that you want to use it for. So I will just call it example right now. And then what it will ask you to do is to add a data structure. So I think especially this sounds a bit techy, but basically if you would compare it to a Google Sheet, all you have to do is you have to add columns. So what you could do is you go here to add, and then here you have to give the structure a name. And what I like to do myself is to just give it the same name as the data store. You can also give it a different name, but for myself, I find it's quite easy. And then we have to set here some specifications. So we want to add what kind of items we want to add to our data store. So all you have to do here is you have to click add item, and then you give basically the column a name. So for example, this could be someone's email address, then you set it to a type. So it can be an array, a collection, a date, text, number, boolean, binary data. So in this case, because we want to store an email address, I would just set the type to text, and we do not have a default. But then if you want, you can make it required so that whenever we add data to the data store, I will show you in a bit how you do that, then this has to be required, otherwise it's not going to work. So if that's important, then set this to required. Multi-line is for if you want to add multiple lines inside that one text thing. Then we click here add, and then you see we basically added the first thing. And then you can add another item. For example, we could say first name, text, and then we do not set a default here. We do not make it required, it's not multi-line. Click here add, and then maybe you could, for example, imagine if this is like some kind of database you're using for appointments, then you can also say appointment date, for example, right? So then you would set this to date, then you also see that these options disappear, and then we can click here add. And then now what we can do is we can just click save, and then you see that the data structure here will be set. Then you can set the data storage size in megabytes. So you see here that it must be lower or equal to than one, must be higher than or equal to one. So it basically has to be one. And this depends a bit on which plan you're using in Integromat. So by default, I think on the free plan, you're allowed to create one data store that is 1 megabyte. And with a paid plan, then you get multiple data stores that are also a bit bigger. So right now I'll just leave this to one. I click save. And then you see that we have our data store. So now, if I click here browse, then you also see a little bit what I mean with this like Google Sheet comparison. So here we have basically a column of email addresses, first names, appointment dates. And then you also see this thing that you might not know, and they call this a key. And this is basically the unique ID of that row, which we're also going to need in some of the modules that I will show you in a bit. But first, let's just add something manually to this database. You can also do that. So here I just click add, then the key, you can set something here, your own ID, but if you leave it empty, then it will just automatically populate something. That's usually what I do. So then email address, you could, for example, say here, Emma Doe, first name Emma, the date of the appointment is here the 23rd, and then we click save. And then you see right now that we have an automatically generated key over here. We have an email address, we have a first name, and we have an appointment date. So this is how you create a data store and also how you can create a data structure. So now let's go over to a scenario so that I can also explain you all the modules that you can use for data stores. So this is the scenario, so this is my example scenario. So I'm just going to show you those modules, but obviously you can use these inside all of your scenarios, right? So to do it, you just click your module where you want to edit, and then you search for data store. If it doesn't appear over here, then we have data store. And then you see that these are the actions that we have. So all these actions are just built in into Integromat. So what we can do is we can add or replace a record. We can update a record, get a record, check the existence of a record, delete a record, delete all records, search records, or count records. Now, for example, imagine we want to add a record to our data store. So all we have to do is we click this, then you have to select the data store that you want to add something to. Then you see here, we can fill out the key if we want to. So usually I just leave it blank so that it automatically generates something random. And then you can also set here, overwrite an existing record. Usually I don't need this, but if you want to, you could do that if you maybe want to replace or update something. So here we just say, okay, Emma Doe, let's change this to John Doe, like something different, John. And then here we have the appointment date. Now let's just for purpose sake here, say that the appointment date is right now. So then I would click here, okay. And then now if I click here, run this module only. So then the data will be stored inside that data store. You see here, okay, cool, was a success. Then here we go over here, we refresh the page, we go here to browse, and then you see now that here it says John Doe, John, and that the appointment date is right now. So obviously you would probably not type these things in here, you would add variables of previous modules. But so that's how that one works. And then what you can also do, which one I also use quite often, is, for example, search records. So if you want to search if maybe something is already inside your data store, then you can just say here, search records. Then you select your data store that you want to search into. And then you get like a filter that you maybe already know from IntegraMod, like a bit similar. And then here you can select the thing you want to search for. So here, for example, I want to search if an email address is equal to, and then let's just make it case insensitive. For example, johndoe@gmail.com. Then I click here, okay. Then I click here, run this module only. And then you see over here that we get an output, one bundle. So it found one thing basically, and this is the record that it found, and this is the key for that record. So then if you search something for that, maybe I wanted to get the first name, or maybe I want to update something in that, or maybe I want to remove this thing from our data store. So then I can also say add another module, data store, and then we could, for example, say delete a record. So maybe it has served its purpose, we don't need it anymore, we just want to delete it. So then we say here, okay, we want to delete something inside this data store. So in this case, it's called example. And then we have to give that key. So that key we know from our previous module. So we just click here, key, click OK, we click here, save. And then now see what happens if I click run once. Then you see that it still found the same person because we didn't remove it, right? And then over here, it deleted that record. So if we go back now to our data store, where we refresh the page, I click browse, you see now that John Doe is gone. So right now, here, if I click run once, then we see over here that nothing was found, and then it's also not continuing because it cannot delete something that does not exist yet. And those are basically the modules that I use most often. I think the other ones are quite obvious what you can do there. Self-explanatory, right? So you can, for example, use like count records, you can update a record, you can get a specific record from the data store. So for example, if you say here, get a record, then I don't find this so super useful. But if I say here, example, then I have to fill out the key. And if the key is automatically generated, then that does not work. But I can maybe imagine that you maybe create a data store of all your customers, and then instead of a random key, maybe you use the email address as the key, and then you can just add the email address over in here, and then it will still get that record. So just keep that in mind that that is also possible. Now then what I want to do is I want to show you two of my favorite use cases. So this is the first one, and this I called my simple Gmail bridge. So I connected my domain name, maxkollenberg.com, with Gmail because I'm using Google Workspaces, so I can use the Gmail module to send emails. And for example, something that I really like to do is to send people emails that follow one of my free courses to ask how they like it. And I'm doing that with the Gmail modules because then the emails really look like they came from me. And I really love to send everyone manual emails, but this way I think it comes across a little bit more personal and I still reply to all their replies. So yeah, this is basically how I do that. So I have a webhook over here. I add it to an automation inside ActiveCampaign so that if somebody followed the third lesson, then this webhook will be triggered, and then this module is going to send an email that says like, hey, how do you like it? Then over here, we have an email in HTML, so it would say something like, hey, Emma, I noticed that you just watched the third lesson of the free course. Awesome. How do you like the course so far? So just like a friendly email, right? But I really want to prevent that that email is somehow sent multiple times. So one thing I'm doing with the data stores is that I created a data store that is called events. And inside the data store, I store which emails I send to people. So what I can do then is I trigger this webhook, right? And then I use the search records module. And then I search for if the email address is equal to the email address of the ActiveCampaign contact. And then if the event name, which is another record in the database, here you can see that we have email, ActiveCampaign ID, event name, and time. So if the event name is equal to email sent, and then sent email is a variable that I add to that webhook, then if there's no event yet, so you can see here, if the key does not exist, then I know like, hey, okay, cool, it did not find anything. So then continue, and then add an event to that database. So here, events database, we add the email address, the ActiveCampaign ID, then event name, email sent, and then this variable over here, time now. So then next time, if for some reason the contact would go into this scenario 2 minutes later again, then it will search events, and this time the key will be found, so it will stop here. So then after that, it just continues to those modules. So that's one of my favorite use cases, that I can just use data stores to prevent things from happening twice. And then my second favorite use case is this one. So this is my Calendly handler, super big scenario. If you want to know how it works, you can check out this video over here where I'm also talking about it. But right now we're just going to talk about this here in the beginning. So this is my Calendly handler, and basically what I'm using it for is to send a confirmation email to everyone who is booking a coaching call with me. So people can use a tool called Calendly to pick a spot directly into my calendar. So then there's also no back and forth emailing of, oh, are you available on Wednesday? Oh no, sorry, what about on Thursday? It's super handy, like you can just pick a spot right to your calendar. And then whenever they schedule a call with me, this module is going to get data. Then I send a confirmation email to that person saying something like, hey, super cool, thanks for booking the call with me. I will see you on this date at this time, and you can use the Zoom link below to join our meeting. So super duper handy, but something that I really wanted to do is I wanted to send a reminder email to those people saying something like, hey, just a reminder, our call is starting within 1 hour, don't forget. Something like that, right? Just like a friendly email. So by default, inside IntegraMod, you cannot have like some kind of module that says like, hey, wait until 1 hour before our coaching call. So what you need to do is you need to store the relevant data for that coaching call inside a data store. And then you need a second scenario, this one, I'll explain this in a bit, to check if there's any calls starting within the next hour. So that works like this. So this tool is going to get data, right? Then here we send a confirmation email, and then we add a reminder record to this data store over here, reminders. You can see this is what it looks like. So here we have our key, email, type of reminder, and then the start time. So then here I say, okay, I want to add a record. So here I add the email address, then I set the type to call because I'm also using this for webinars, super handy. And then also the start time of our call. So these data I both get from Calendly, and this one I just typed in here myself. And then we have this scenario. Then you see that this is a scheduled scenario. So you see this little clock over here. And then you see that we run this scenario at a regular intervals. So we run it every 30 minutes. Every 30 minutes, this scenario is going to start from 8 in the morning till 6 in the evening, because those are my work times. And then here we search records. So we search for a start time that is earlier than now plus 90 minutes. So I'm using here the add minutes function. You can also check out my date functions tutorial if you want to learn how that works. But basically what I'm doing here, I say now plus 90 minutes. And then if the start time inside our data store is earlier than that, then I know, hey, our call is starting within the next 90 minutes. So then it is going to continue because the key exists. then we delete that reminder because I do not want to send another reminder 30 minutes later. So here we have delete a record, then we use the key from the previous module. Then here I have a router, and then it's going to check the type of reminder. So if it's a call, it will go over here. It sends a reminder for our call. And if it's a webinar, then it will send an email about that webinar. So I find this super duper handy, and I really love it to use it for my calls and also my webinars. But yeah, this is how you can use data stores inside IntegraMod. I hope this cleared some things up. I know that when I got started with IntegraMod, I was really like, wow, what are these data stores? I had no clue, but it's actually really simple, right? It's like some kind of Google Sheet or database. You put things in it that you can then use on a later moment. If you have any questions about it, just let me know in the comments below. And I also created a really cool IntegraMod cheat sheet, which you can also find in the description of this video if you want to learn more tips and tricks like this.